Welcome back, astronomers! Have you ever been outside during a clear night and looked up in amazement at the vastness of outer space? What is out there? What are all of those tiny little dots? How many of them are there? How far away are they? Ancient civilizations thought the stars were larger-than-life characters, indicators that time had passed, or mythological creatures. Now, with the advancement of technology and tools we have today, we know much more about these previously mysterious objects. Today, we'll take a deep dive into one of the most interesting objects in the universe, stars. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to describe stars and their physical characteristics and explain the importance of stars. You've probably seen hundreds, if not thousands, of stars in your life. But have you ever thought about what they actually are? A star is a large celestial object made up of gas and dust that produces energy. Every single star that astronomers have discovered is made up of mostly two elements, or pure substances. These elements are very common on Earth as well. Pause the video here and write down which two elements you think make up stars in your guided notes. Which two elements did you guess? If you said hydrogen and helium, you were spot on. Every star is made up of almost entirely these two elements. For example, our closest star, the Sun, is made up of 74% hydrogen and 25% helium, with the remaining 1% being other heavier elements. Although they're made of the same things, stars come in all different shapes and sizes. Let's think about the size of our Sun first. It's a pretty average-sized star, but it's big enough to fit over 1 million Earths inside of it. There are stars out in the universe that are as small as 1/12 of the size of our Sun, all the way up to 150 times larger than it. I mean, check out how huge the star Betelgeuse is in comparison. And did you notice that these stars have different colors too? Stars also vary widely in temperature, which determines the color of the star. The hottest stars are blue, followed by blue-white, yellow, orange, then red being the coolest. Our Sun is a mid-level star in terms of temperature, at about 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Some blue stars are as much as 50 times hotter than our Sun, while the coolest red ones aren't even hot enough to boil water. The last characteristic of stars we'll be discussing today is the luminosity. Luminosity means the total amount of energy emitted by a star. Astronomers can use a star's luminosity to learn quite a bit about the star. It helps determine the star's size because larger stars tend to have higher luminosities because they have more surface area to give off light. Now it's your turn to think like an astronomer. Imagine two stars have exactly the same luminosity, but one of them appears quite bright in the night sky and the other appears to be dim. What conclusion could you reach about the distance from Earth of these two stars? Pause the video here and make your prediction in your guided notes. Stellar work! If two stars have the same luminosity, but one appears bright and one appears dim, that must mean that the brighter one is closer to Earth and the dimmer one is farther away from Earth. Characteristics like size, color, and luminosity help us understand the stars we see in the night sky. Now, let's take a moment to examine why stars are so important for us and for our understanding of the universe as a whole. Pause the video here and write down a few of your predictions for why stars are so important in your guided notes. First of all, stars are the source of heat and light for the planets that orbit them. That means that if we didn't have our Sun, all the living things on Earth, including us, wouldn't be able to survive. Stars are also the building blocks of our universe. A star is what our solar system revolves around, literally. Stars are also what make up the billions of galaxies that astronomers have been able to observe and study. Stars have also been used to help people navigate for thousands of years. Since stars are so far away that they don't seem to move very much in the night sky relative to Earth, they make excellent reference points. Ancient Polynesians used stars as celestial landmarks to navigate the Pacific Ocean. In more recent times, sailors have taken advantage of the star Polaris, also known as the North Star, to always know which way is north during their travels. And finally, stars are simply fascinating. These amazing cosmic structures make up so much of our universe, and yet there is still so much left for us to learn about them. It was only in the last 100 years that astronomers even discovered that there were other galaxies besides our own in space. Just think about how much more we will be able to learn and discover in the next 100 years. Thank you for joining me today for our star-hopping trip through the universe. Let's recap what we've learned today. You now know that stars are large celestial objects made of gas and dust. Stars have a wide variety of physical characteristics, including their size, color, temperature, and luminosity. Stars are extremely important to life on Earth. Humans have relied on them for thousands of years, and we are still learning more about them all the time. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson as you continue your journey into the universe. And as always, remember, you are out of this world. Hey!